Hello, my name is Ryan Britt, and alongside Shoji Bixby, we created the VR Art Museum for Bing Huang's final project, and in this video, I'm just going to go over what we had to do to pull this all off. So we needed to get some 3D models via photogrammetry, and so we went to the Met, which is in New York, but unfortunately they didn't allow any videos, so this is all we got. So then we made our way to RISD Museum about a week later, and went to the Chinese art exhibit. And we kind of gravitated towards this one Buddha head. And you can just see me right now taking pictures of said Buddha head. And the way that photogrammetry works is pretty much based, in layman terms, on perspective geometry. It takes a bunch of points from the 90 or so pictures that I've taken and kind of mesh them together to form a 3D model in a program called Autodesk Recap. And right now, I'm just kind of cleaning up the image. Sometimes through photogrammetry you get these chunks that kind of render in, and it's my job to kind of go in and clean it up so that all we're left with is that the one Buddha head that I could later send in to Shoji. After I'm done kind of cleaning it up, I upload it via OBX file to Shoji so that he can then implement it into the world that he's creating right now. So through Unreal Engine and through their workshop, you can download different assets. And right now Shoji's using an asset that was kind of this Tibetan themed that he made this world out of. Right now you can just see him closing the doors and just setting everything up. Those boxes that you saw earlier and that he's kind of putting in right now is what's allowing the player to spawn in and to freely walk around. Now he's pulling up the OBX file of the head that I brought to him. He's kind of scaling it up and just moving the axis so that he can put it on top of these two tables. So now we're going to be looking at the coding aspect and being able to teleport to and from the different areas regarding the multiple artifacts. The coding for Unreal Engine is kind of block-based as opposed to text-based, which makes coding seem more like a drag-and-drop activity rather than typing in lines. But through the process behind it, it's pretty much all the same. So this is testing the teleport function in the sarcophagus map, which is where the kind of Roman-themed artifacts are that we captured in the Met. As you can see, Shoji's going through some issues regarding the mapping for the placement of where you can and can't teleport, making the places that you were able to teleport bug out a little bit, which is why he's kind of going in and out. So after fiddling with it for a little bit and the location of the playable area, he was able to find kind of this happy medium so that the player could teleport and still view everything that needed to be viewed. And after the trial and error stages, he was able to get that full demo up and running. And right now we're just going to go through the full thing. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy it. So right now Shoji has on his VR headset. He's using the HTC Vibe and he's currently in the lobby. He's looking at the Tibetan theme over there and the Roman theme right now, which is what we're going to visit first. He's kind of pointing at the some of the assets that he put up to kind of liven up the room. Now he's going to teleport over to some other assets that he put in to kind of help with the Roman vibe and aesthetic that we're trying to go for here. You know, he kind of put up some drapes, he put in the fire pits, it just helps with the overall theme. Now Shoji is looking at another object that we captured via photogrammetry, except this one was from the Harvard Art Museum. It actually comes from a Roman villa off the coast of northern Rome, roughly from the first century. So it is from a Roman villa, and so the theme that we're going to teleport to right now is going to be a Roman villa that Shoji got via another Roman asset that he kind of put together to make this world. As you can see, he did a really good job with the columns, the gold finishes, the blue sky he built the world in. So everything just looks really good. So now we're going to be teleporting to the actual statue. You can see the detail that the Autodesk Recap is able to capture in 3D models. The camera that we used definitely helps. Professor Huang was gracious enough to let us use her Canon 6D Mark II, and so that definitely helps capture all the detail. Yeah, and you can just see, you know, the crevices of the nose, and the hair. It came together real nicely. Now, should you just tap the head like that, and it teleports him back to the lobby. Now we're looking at a Roman bust of a man from 1st century that we captured at the Met using photogrammetry again. And look, just look at the detail. I mean, it's incredible. Now we're going to be going over to the sarcophagus to the right. This one was given to us by Professor Huang from RISD, actually. This one isn't a 3D model. It's only 2D, but we're still very happy to have it. And look, just looking at the detail again, you know, it's pretty amazing what Autodesk is able to do with the pictures. So touching the head like that, we're brought to the room. It's lit very nicely because of the fire in the middle that showed you took a while to program. Now we're going to go over to the bust that he put on these pillars. Again, they look very nice, and it's just going to be the entrance to the sarcophagus. The Roman one with, you know, with the details on it. It looks incredible. One thing I think we definitely want to do in the future is kind of add the information on the actual sarcophagus. So, you know, the date, who it was made by, you know, just stuff like that I think would be helpful. But going forward, we're going to the Buddha section, Chinese art, using the Tibetan theme. You know, should you put up the flags, the bell, you know, again, to go along with the theme. He's currently looking at the 3D model that, you know, I was going in Autodesk Recap, just fixing up. You can see the sides and the edges, just a little bit of the back sticking out, but, you know, nothing too crazy. And now we're just going to go over, touch the head, and bam. You know, we're in the Tibetan kind of world that Shoji set up for us. You know, one minor thing that I think is pretty cool that Unreal Engine adds is ambient occlusion, which is kind of how light affects different surfaces and how you kind of get these shadows on the objects. You know, just something cool that it adds. Shoji's teleporting to the, you know, the Buddha heads that we rendered and that you saw him placing in. And yeah, it just looks really good. You know, at the end of the day, I think one thing that we really agreed upon was that what we want to do with this is just bring it to someone who doesn't necessarily have the ability to, you know, go to the Met and be able to see these items, you know, face to face. And, you know, VR brings someone who lives in rural Arkansas the ability to look at a Roman statue from like a century ago. I think it's pretty incredible. But yeah, just wrapping things up. You can go up on the balcony. Shuji's gonna go back down to the floor and just tap on the door to bring us back to the lobby. And yeah, that pretty much wraps it up. I hope you enjoyed watching the video tutorial of the VR Art Museum. I've been Ryan Britt. That was Shuji Bixby. And thank you very much.